비슷한 단어들을 얘기 나눠봤으니까 이제는 좀 차이가 있는 근데 서로 잘 모르는 슬랭들을 얘기를 해보도록 할게요.
Capsicum is used also in New Zealand, right? Capsicum? Or do you say bell pepper?
Bell pepper.
Bell pepper? Oh, no. We know what bell peppers are, but we say capsicum in Australia. How about like gosu? Like the, do you say coriander?
Ah, coriander.
Yeah, not cilantro. I didn't know what cilantro was until I came to Korea. So we use coriander as well.
Coriander 뭐라고 부른다고?
Cilantro.
처음 들어봐.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I didn't know about that either, actually, until I came to Korea, because Korea has it on their menu for English speakers. So they put cilantro, not coriander.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay. It's terrible anyway. Either way. Yeah, I don't like it.
Gender?
Gender. So in Australia, we say thongs. But actually, I don't know if you know, but like thong
is tippenty.
Tippenty, right? So that's why we say like thongs, like books, we plural it, right? So we call them
thong.
No. Because we don't say tippenty either. We say like, I don't know,
G-string.
Yeah, we say G-string. But like, I've heard people use the expression like double pluggers, double pluggers as well, to mean the same thing. Why would you call them jandals? Why jandals?
확실하진 않지만 Japanese
이라고
들었어.
See, I'm learning. I'm learning new things as well.
맞아.
Scots.
이거의 유래는 좀 어린 남자애들이 여자들 꼬시려고 좀 멋있게 입었을 때 Scots, bro. 이제 그거에서 더 나아가서 그냥 누군가 약간 멋진 행동. 야, 너 멋있는데? 할 때 그냥 스커트 이렇게 말을 하더라고요.
So you said like young people use it, right?
좀 어린, 약간 한국 말로 하자면 급식체 같은 거.
Alright. Oh, no, I really can't think of any other word for Scots.
호주 급식체. 급식이 아니어서 모르는 거 아니야?
If you know another word for Scots.
완전 뉴질랜드 거네요.
Yeah, that one is New Zealand, definitely. If you know any sort of word that is similar in Australian, you could probably comment below, but I honestly don't know that
one. Mm. 이거는 안 쓰네.
네? Well, I think we do use like, I don't care.
비슷한데? 이거는 약간, 저거 음식 먹어봤어?
Right.
네.
네, 네. Like, like, how's the movie?
네.
I'm like, yeah.
아, 그럼 이건 비슷한 거네.
Right. Not good, not bad, just, you know, so, sort of like,
별로.
Like,
아니면 also, 그냥 그래.
Yeah. Like, so.
Short.
The only time I would use short is like if people are playing golf or like playing basketball and it's like a good hit or
good shot.
Good shot.
Right.
I don't know if we use it the same
이렇게,
way.
예를 들면 우리가 thank you 대신에 cheers 쓰는 것처럼 cheers 대신에 그냥 shot 할 수도 있어.
Then I don't think Australians use that.
그러면 then. 살짝 다른 거.
Right. So like I said, we just use it for like talking about sports.
그런 상황에서만 쓰고.
That's different as well.
그리고 chuck.
Chuck. We use chuck. Like chuck is a bicky. Like you know, do you know what bicky is? If I say chuck is a bicky, it's kind of like give me a biscuit.
Bicky.
Biscuit. We use like chuck as in like throw, like chuck a ball is the throw ball.
뭐, 이거 저기 쓰레기통 버시면
right.
Chuck it in the rubbish bin.
Right. We use chuck like that.
쿠마라. 쿠마라 들어봤어.
No.
쿠마라는 저도 되게 놀랐는데 고구마라는 건데 우리도 어차피 한국에서 미국식 영어를 배우니까 스윗 포테이토인 줄 알고 있었는데 뉴질랜드에서는 고구마를 쿠마라라고 패스트푸드점 같은 데 갔을 때도 포테이토 칩 대신에 쿠마라 칩 되게 맛있고 많이 있어요.
I think we just said sweet potato. I think I'm pretty sure there's no other word for us. But so do you say like kumara fries?
아니 kumara chips.
New Zealanders say like chili bin.
Chili bin. 나 chili bin 아니고.
No.
Chili bin.
Chili.
This is a chili bin because it's a bin that keeps things chilled.
I can't say it. But in like Australia, it's Esky because it's an Esky is a the brand name of a popular. Chilibin. Do you hear New Zealanders say like g'day? Like g'day is 100% Australian. I don't care who says it.
How's dad?
G'day. How's dad? Very funny, but It is Australian. I'm pretty sure it's Australian. I would bet a lot of money it's Australian.
발음 얘기를 해볼까? 발음?
아 그래.
나는 원래 호주 발음을 더 좋아하긴 했는데 뉴질랜드에서 생활을 해보니까 뉴질랜드 발음이 되게 매력 있어. 예를 들면 아까도 말했듯이 칠리빈?
Australia. Australia is like chili bin.
This is a chili bin. Chili bin.
Chili bin.
그리고 fish and chips 어떻게?
All right. Fish and chips.
우리는 fish and chips.
Australians call this a fish when it's clearly a fish. A fish.
그러니까 우리는 약간 e가 들어가면 그거는 진짜 e라고
하면
예를 들면 seven 아니고 seven.
Seven. All right. Seven. Seven.
달걀도 e.
Right. I can't do it. I'm terrible at it.
20.
20? 20? 20.
20.
Alright. So the E is definitely...
그리고 또 I 발음이 돼요. I가 들어가는 거는 약간 E보다는 U 발음이라서 예를 들면 chili라고 하는 거예요. Chili.
Chili.
Bin 말고 bin.
Bin? Alright. Bin. You guys say bin. In Australia, we have like the two kinds of accents, and one is like country style accent, and one is like more general. I guess I don't know how to explain it.
표준어 느낌.
Right. So like as an example, we have what's called like sometimes it's negative, sometimes people don't think it's negative, but like it's like we say like bogan as well, like country style. Those people have like oh yeah man, like oh yeah mate. The voice kind of goes higher. It's like oh g'day mate, how you going? Sort of.
이렇게
For people who usually live in urban areas, it's a bit less sort of country style.
그럼 어디에 더 가까워?
I lived in both places. So when I was growing up, I would like hang around people who would like have that, oh yeah, that really Aussie true blue accent. And then I would move to the city and then it would be less common, but you know, it just depends on the person
그치,
그치, as well. 맞아. But like New Zealand as well, it's like the Maoris and the, you know.
좀 아일랜더나 마오리들은 조금 더 그쪽 발음?
Right.
더 현지인 같은 발음을
쓰고. Right. There's definitely a big difference. Whenever I met like New Zealanders in Australia, whenever I meet like Maori guys, their accents were like very, very different, I thought. So it's quite interesting because it's quite a soft accent, in my opinion, like the Maori accent. Very nice to listen to. But the guys are like usually like really big guys.
같은 느낌.
At one point in Australia, like Maori guys, they were really popular for being like bouncers at the clubs, like the security guards. But like the women as well, like I've got a lot of New Zealand female friends and their accent is also very different if they're like islander or if they're like...
맞아. 그리고 아일랜더들은 영어도 자기네 그 아일랜드만의 특징이 있게 말을 하고 또 자기네 언어가 또 따로 있단 말이야. 사모아에서 쓰는 사모안이 있고 피지에서 쓰는 또 피지에서 쓰는 언어가 다 따로 있어서
right.
진짜 발음이 다 특이해. Yes, 네, 지금까지 호주와 뉴질랜드 사이의 슬랭들의 차이점과 또 비슷한 점들을 알아봤고 오늘 말씀해드린 내용들이 여러분들이 실제 현지에 가서 유용하게 사용할 수 있는 슬랭들 되길 바랍니다. 지금까지 시청해주셔서 감사드리고 오늘 내용이 재밌으셨다면 좋아요와 구독 잊지 마세요. 그리고 제 친구 채널도 방문해주셔서 보시면 되게 재밌는 내용들이 많으니까 구경해보시고 또 구독도 해주시면 좋을 것 같습니다. 그럼 다음 시간에 또 만나요. 안녕.
Bye. Awesome.